So today I will discuss about the natural killer cells or NK cells. So these cells are very important in our immune system. They play a very important role in our immune system, as because they are the one of the most important part of the innate immunity. So these cells, by default, they can destroy the different pathogenic substances. Rather than say they are responsible for destroying the cells which are affected by the pathogens. So natural killer cell, they are nothing but the originating from the same progenitor cells from where the lymphocytes are being originated, and so they are called as the same family of the T and B cells, and they are coming from the common progenitors, and they are one of the most important part of innate immune system. However, they also helps the other cells like the macrophages and dendritic cells for their activation and for enhancement of their activities also. So by this process, natural killer cell plays an important role in immunity. So it why it is called a natural killer cell? As because it has the ability to kill the tumor cell without any priming or prior activation. That's why it is called as natural killer cell. And not only that, it also can destroy the virus affected cell automatically without any presence of other cell surface antigen or like that. So when the cell is affected, that cell can be destroyed by these cells, and these cells actually leads to the apoptosis of the particular infected cell. So natural killer cell plays a critical role in innate response, basically for the viruses, tumors and fungal infections. They are the large granular lymphocytes. Very important, they are large granular lymphocytes. So they are they belong to the lymphocyte family, and they are larger in size, and they are found throughout the tissue of the body and mainly in the circulation. So they can be found in everywhere in the body, and mainly they are found in the circulation. And about 5 to 15% of the circulatory lymphocytes are natural killer cells. They contain cytotoxins. Cytotoxins are chemicals which is toxic to the cell for protection against viruses. And they play a crucial role in the defense against tumor. So tumor cell can be destroyed by the natural killer cell. They kills the infected cell and induce apoptosis. They kills the infected cells. That means the cell which has been infected by the virus, they can be destroyed by this natural killer cell. That means it is directly destroying the cell which is infected itself, and it induces the apoptosis of that particular cell. Apoptosis means, what do you mean by apoptosis? Apoptosis is the programmed cell death. That means cell is died with the help of natural killer cell programmatically. So how it can be done? It can be done by releasing some substances. Side by side, it helps to activate the T cell mediated immunity. So T cell mediated immunity is activated by the natural killer cell. So natural killer cell, one side it is destroying the virus affected cell or affected cell. Another side it is stimulating the immune system for its activation. So by this process, it plays a major role within our body. So these, how they are, what is their localization? They can found throughout the tissues of the body, as I told earlier, mainly in the circulation, and they comprise about 5 to 15% of the total lymphocyte fractions. They are the large granular lymphocytes, and they are the large granular lymphocytes. And how they can be differentiated from the lymphocyte? So they are large in size. They are larger in size than the lymphocytes, and they contain more cytoplasm. They are larger in size and they can contain more cytoplasm within them, and they have electron dense granule within the cytoplasm. So these are the characteristic feature by which they can be differentiated from the normal lymphocytes. So what are the points? Number one, they are larger than the lymphocytes, and they contain more cytoplasm in the than the lymphocytes, and they have electron dense granules. So by this process, the natural killer cell can be differentiated by these features. The natural killer cell can be differentiated from the lymphocyte. So, and another thing, they are CD3 negative lymphocytes which do not express antigen specific receptors at their surfaces. So these natural killer cells, they are not having CD3 receptors within their surface, whereas the lymphocytes are having CD3 receptors. So they are lacking of the CD3 component from their surfaces. By this process, they can be identified, and they are produced in the bone marrow from the common lymphoid progenitor, as we told earlier. That is where from the B and T lymphocytes are produced. They are produced by this common progenitor, and they are differentiated, and they are circulated throughout the circulation so that it can destroy the infected cells which are infected by virus, fungus, or pathogens, or any other pathogens. So these are the, you can see here that these lymphoid, common lymphoid progenitor cell, they are responsible for maturation of the natural killer cell and T lymphocyte and B lymphocyte. So T lymphocyte, B lymphocyte, and natural killer cell, they are being produced from the same progenitor cell, which are responsible for production of the lymphocytes. So it is bigger in size, and it is having larger cytoplasmic constituent. They are having the cytoplasmic content more, and they are having the cytoplasmic granules also are there. So another thing is that very interesting feature, they have surface receptor for IgG, that is for Fc portion of the IgG, and they are, that means these natural killer cells, they are having different types of receptors, among which one of the important receptor is Fc receptor for IgG. It is called as Fc gamma R3 type. So these receptors are responsible for binding with the Fc portion of the immunoglobulin G. Immunoglobulin, you know that the immunoglobulin G is a type of the immunoglobulin, and it has the Fc portion. For that Fc portion, that Fc portion is can be recognized by the receptor which is present on the surface of the natural killer cell, and that is called as Fc receptor for immunoglobulin G. Like that, it also contains another two types of receptor, that is the surface receptors for cell surface molecules like killer activation receptor, or KARS, and killer inhibition receptor, KIRS. So these two types of receptors, they are responsible for recognizing the cell, whether it has to it will be destroyed by the natural killer cell or not. So binding with these receptors, binding with the receptors with the of the natural killer cells with the these component, that is the MHC1 of the target cell, and activating ligand of the target cell, actually they actually determines whether the cell will be destroyed or not. So killer activation receptor and killer inhibition receptor, their function is contradictory to each other, and they helps in initiation of the apoptosis of the, or they helps in regulation of the apoptosis of the cell which are, which already has been infected by the virus. So on the next class, I will discuss about the functions of the natural killer cell, how they kills the pathogenic substances, how they kills the cells which are infected by the pathogens.